So we've seen how we can use a variable to take an input from a player and then compare that variable with what they type in and run a block of code depending on what they type in. So in the case of above, if they type in R, it will run this code that is indented. If they don't type in R, if they type in anything else, it will skip that and it will move whatever's indented under the else. Okay, now you can see here I have not indented the next load of code, and that's because this section of the game is over. Okay, they've either chosen choice R or they've chosen something else. Okay, and this part has come to an end. So we move on to the next section in the game. And as we've said before, code executes line by line. So it would execute this next, which is a sleep command, then a print statement, then another sleep command, then two more print statements, setting up the next sort of selection choice we have to make in our game. So previously, we had a choice out of two things. Okay, we could either run away or use magic, and that took into account the if and the else. Now, you can have an unlimited amount of choices, and you use something called elif. Okay, elif, it kind of means if else, basically. So the way we can work it is we can make our next variable, and this time we'll call it choice 2. Okay, now you know I've not called it the same, because if we call it the same, it can cause problems. So I'm going to call it choice 2, just to avoid any confusion. And I want an input statement, because I want the user to be able to type something in. And in this case, we want to see what happens when we encounter this rabbit. Okay, so we could have, say, press S to stroke it, press K to kill it, or press, let's say, R to run away. Okay. So we've got now three options. So how do we express this in an if and else statement? Well, we start off with the same thing we did before. If choice 2 is exactly equal to S, which is stroke it, remembering our colon and speech marks, because it's a string the user will be typing in, it automatically indents for us. Okay, so now we put in what we want to happen if they choose choice 2. So we'll say print the bunny reveals its fangs and bites your hand off. Okay, and I could probably say lives minus 1 there. Okay, we'll pop that in. Again, indented under the print statement, and then you have X amount of lives left. I'm just going to copy that, paste it in, and make sure it all lines up. Okay, so if we choose S, those three things will happen. Now I'm going to come out of the if statement by unindenting it. So you can see the cursor is now unindented. And I'm going to use something called elif. Okay, and elif is a bit like if. Okay, but you put it in between if and else statements. So elif choice 2 is equal to K to kill it. Remembering to put it in speech marks. Okay. And then we can have print the rabbit reveals its fangs, but you chop it in two. Okay, slightly violent game this. And then we can get some points for that. So I'll just copy these from up here because it's the same code. Okay, and again, I'm just going to indent all that. Okay, there we go, lovely. And we then finish it with an else. Okay, and the else would be if we pressed R to run away. So again, that's not the right option, so we'll go print the bunny catches you and eats you. Okay, and then we can have this situation where we lose a life as well. Okay, so we've got elif giving us another choice. Now, actually, you can use elif as many times as you like. So we could have a fourth choice, okay, So we could have another button up here, then we'd just put in another elif, all right? And that would work quite happily. Now, the way to always set this up is you always start with an if, you always end with an else, and anything in between is an elif, okay? Don't use kind of multiple ifs, because again, we won't go into it now, but that may mess your code up, okay? So always use elif in the middle. One if at the start, one else at the end, and as many elifs as you want for choices in the middle. Okay, so let's test that and see what happens. What I will do actually is just put a little thing at the bottom, which will, oh no, I won't bother actually. Let's just run that. Okay, so get Bob going again. And we'll see if we can get the code and the output up at the same time. Here we go. So it was E to use magic to get past this bit. Okay, so my score's 5. You can see that. And we'll do the correct one, so K to kill it. Okay, now you can see there it's added 5 to my score. Okay, so the variable was added on 5 to give me a total score of 10. All right. And then, as you would normally do when you're testing your code, just test all the other things. So we'll test... So we know the first one works, so we'll just use the magic against the old crone. There we go. And we will test this time the stroke it, S to stroke. So this should take away one life. Okay, cool, good. The else would work as well, I'm sure, but I won't test it on camera, but that's what you would do. So for multiple choices, use as many elifs as you like in between an if and the else. And don't forget, anything you want to happen inside an elif, an else, or an if statement must be indented, okay? And then you unindent it once you want something completely new to happen.